Hi everyone, it's Carolina from Gotta Love Polish. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome if you're new. So in today's video, I'm gonna share with you guys my wish list for Hella Handmade Creation July of 2021. If you like this video, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment down below and let me know if you are getting any of the polishes or products from Hella Handmade Creation in July of 2021. If you don't know what Hella Handmade Creation is, also known as HHC, it is a site where different brands each feature different polishes or products based on a theme. The brand commits to participating for a minimum of 4 months, and each brand chooses their own theme and will create one polish per month inspired by that theme. HHC opens up on the 14th of every month through the 21st of every month. I will have all the information down below. So obviously this is a really short timed video because I am waiting to the last second to post this, to create this and post this for my wish list. The first polish on my wish list is Atomic Polish, and this is Kandra. I wanna say Kandra, is that correct? It's gonna be $12.50, and there will be no cap. And when I say no cap, that means that there will not be a cutoff of how many polishes. Certain brands only have a certain amount of polishes that they're gonna bring to the theme for the month. Other brands have no cap. That means it's a pre-order format, and you will be able to order as many as you'd like. Atomic Polish brings us Kandra. Kandra is a color shifting flaky jelly polish. It has a deep violet base with a heavy blue to purple shift. It is also filled with flakes that shift aqua green to blue. It's opaque in 2 to 3 coats depending on the application. I would probably do a third coat because that's just me. And this is the next polish in her Mistborn series, and it's inspired by the Kandra people. Is that how you say it? I feel like I'm saying it wrong. So I am into blues and pinks this season. For this, like, basically since summer started, all I've been wanting to wear are bright, hot pinks or super intense blues. I don't know why. And this polish is screaming for me to purchase it. I feel like I have something that might be similar to this, but these pictures are so gosh darn beautiful that I'm like, you know you want this. You know you need this. Just get it. The next polish I'm gonna talk about is Bee's Knees Lacquer Meteorite. And I know I did receive this for PR already for this month, but I'm telling you, if I had not received it, this would be on my wish list. So I'm trying to make my videos as honest as I can and let you guys know, yeah, I would have totally bought this. This is just like right up my alley. Bee's Knees Lacquer's Meteorite is the next polish in the Ghost Adventure series. Meteorite is a pale gray polish with glowy green shimmer loaded with hollow flakes, and it is inspired by the time Zach and Aaron chased each other with cow pies. It is gonna be $13. There will be no cap on this one. I can tell you by the fact that I've already used this polish, it is an amazing formula. I wanna say that I got mine opaque in 2 coats, but I did do a third just in case, because in certain lights, well, in certain, and I use air quotes with this, studio lights that I have in my room, which are just like Ott lights and a ring light, since it's so bright, it would actually make my visible nail line show a little bit, but just a smidgen. And it's just really that third coat was just for me. It wasn't necessary. I just put it in there. Next on my wish list is Bluebird Lacquer, and this is Dollar Dollar Spoonbill, y'all. This is gonna be $12 and there will be no cap. Bluebird Lacquer continues the Beautiful Birds from Around the World series and brings us Dollar Dollar Spoonbill, y'all. It is a bright pink jelly filled with shifting iridescent flakes. So this is inspired by the rosette spoonbill, and this, I think I'm saying it right, this bird has been hunted almost to extinction, but due to conservation efforts, it's making a comeback. These beautiful birds get their pink hue from the food they eat, such as crustaceans and other aquatic life. Every bottle that you purchase means $1 donation to a rescue. For July, Bluebird Lacquer is donating to Feline Fix. This is a nonprofit spay and neuter organization. Keeping cat populations down means bird populations go up. So One, I absolutely love the fact that she is like donating for different rescues, and I think Feline Fix is an amazing program. We have donated to them in the past. This polish is so pretty. It's so pretty. It's what I'm gravitating towards. I told you guys earlier on, I'm looking at pinks, I'm looking at blues, and these two blue and pink polishes that I've been talking about in this video so far are like right up my alley right now. This is like a hot, hot, hot neon pink. I love it. It's so beautiful. Because I'm gravitating towards them, I think I probably have something that will fit the bill for this, but this is my wish list. Next, we have Esmaltes de Kelly, Katinga Sky. Katinga Sky? Yeah, sure, we'll go with that. It's $12.50, and there will be a cap on this one of 100 bottles only. EDK, or Esmaltes de Kelly, continues the Brazil series with Katinga Sky. Katinga Sky is described as a magnetic multi-chrome that shifts pink, green, and yellow. Oh my God, guys. I have been skipping out on almost every EDK magnetic for some reason. Like, I always have it on my wish list and then I skip on it. I don't think I'm gonna skip on this one. I think this is like a must buy for me because it's so unique to anything that I have. Actually, all of their magnetics have been so unique, but then there's always one, either funds or one polish that like outshines it at the moment. Sorry guys, my phone rang there. So I don't know where I was, but I think I was talking about how Esmaltes de Kelly has been making fantastic magnetics, and I haven't been purchasing them like a fool. Next, I have Girly Bits Flower Pot Rocks. It is $13.50, and there will be a 300 bottle cap to this polish. Girly Bit brings us Flower Pot Rocks, and it is the next polish in the Canadian Road Trip series. Flower Pot Rocks is a pale blue with strong pink to gold shifting shimmer and scattered holographic flakes. Flower Pot Rocks is inspired by Hopewell Rocks in New Brunswick, Canada. This polish is so beautiful. It's so, like, to me, it looks almost like a spring polish, but I can see it working in the winter as well. It's beautiful. It's so sparkly. I'm probably not gonna get this one just because I feel like I have something super similar to this in the form of Blush Lacquer's Making Waves, which I wore very recently, like in June, I think I wore it. So I think I'm going to skip on this one, but it is so pretty. Like, it just gravitates, like my eyes just automatically gravitate to that one because of course it's like, it has a pink shift and it's kind of like purpley base. Oh, so pretty. Next we have Night Owl Lacquer, and this is Nadra. I think I'm saying that right. This will be $13 and there will be no cap. Night Owl Lacquer brings us Nadra. And Nadra is a bright aqua with purple blue shimmer filled with green, blue, purple, and purple, blue, green crystal chameleon flakes. This is the last polish on the Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild series that she's been doing. Oops. That she's been doing. So I really love this. I love aqua polishes. It's like my weakness, especially in the summer. Like the minute I see an aqua, I'm like, yeah, I need to wear that. I need to have that. I have so many aquas. Aquas don't always love me, but I always buy them because it's like, oh, and Night Owl Lacquer does such an amazing job with her flakies that I, like, to me, I feel like I'm gonna have severe FOMO if I miss out on this one. Paradox Polish, nothing heals old wounds like opening fresh ones. Love that. It's very morbid. This is $12.50 and there will be no cap. Paradox Polish continues their series inspired by Supernatural, which I love. I love Supernatural. Sorry, my voice sounds weird, guys. I don't know. I think I'm maybe coming down with something else. Nothing heals old wounds like opening fresh ones is described as a berry-ish red magnetic with hollow glitters. It is inspired by Rowena in episode 11. I'm gonna be honest, this one I may not get, but it's so pretty. I don't know, maybe I'll get this one. I don't know, it's so pretty. It's calling to me, but at the same time, I'm like, oh my gosh. I don't know, I'm trying to not buy everything because I am supposed to go to PolishCon, and like, but everything is so pretty. It's so beautiful. I don't know, there's something about this that totally draws me in. And of course, last but not least is wildflower lacquer, and this is Curious Oysters. This is $13, and this will begin Wildflower Lacquer's new series on Hella Handmade Creation, and this series is inspired by Alice in Wonderland. I do believe it's Alice in Wonderland, the Disney animated version. This one is Curious Oysters, which is described as a light lilac base with strong aqua to pink to purple shifting shimmer and scattered hollow. There will be no cap on this one. Oh my gosh, this is so, so, so stinking pretty. You know how I feel about grays and white polishes. They're my kryptonite right now, and Wildflower Lacquer has been killing it because I love shimmers, and she does a lot of shimmers and she does a lot of flakies, and I'm just like, buy everything because I feel like I need everything. So this one I think I'm gonna have to get. It's too gosh darn pretty to skip out on. I love it. Those are the polishes that I have on my wish list for Hella Handmade Creation. So, as per usual, let me know in the comments down below, what are you getting for Hella Handmade Creation, if you're getting anything at all, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!